Representative Teresa Ledger Fernandez, thank you for joining me to talk for a few minutes about PFAS today.
Well, thank you for having me. This is such an important subject for New Mexico and for my district.
Excellent. So the U.S. House recently passed an amendment of yours to the PFAS Action Act that would apply to Highland Dairy down in Clovis, New Mexico. Can you talk a little bit about the amendment and also the bill that passed the House?
So what we passed at the House was the PFAS Action Act because we knew that we needed to address this forever chemicals. They last forever. And the bill would require that it be studied and that PFAS be cleaned up and that we study and set limits for how much can we have PFAS, how much of the chemical can we have in our drinking water. I recognized that that was not enough, that we needed to make sure that we studied and limited and then eliminated PFAS in our food supply as well. This is an example of how an issue at home in our wonderfully diverse and beautiful Third Congressional District is going to help out everybody across the country. So that was my amendment to make sure it was included in this food supply to protect the food supply. But it came out of the fact that Highland Dairy by Clovis, New Mexico has been ruined. Because of PFAS in the groundwater there. The cows drank the water that was contaminated and they ate the grass that was contaminated. So the milk from the dairy could no longer be sold in the market and the cows themselves could also not be sold.
So as if I understand correctly, you've also been talking with Mr. Scopp about what USDA might be able to do about his cows, which like you said, can't be sold. He can't even sell them for like dog food. How might USDA be able to help him and maybe other farmers out?
The USDA has a program where they are allowed to purchase milk. For example, if the EPA has determined and the USDA has determined that that milk is contaminated. So the USDA actually purchased milk from him to account for the fact that the milk had been contaminated through no fault of his own. But they didn't have a way of purchasing the cows themselves, because that's what you need to do. Those cows cannot be used. We do not want them in the market. They did not have a way of doing that. Now, the legislature, thanks to the great work of Senator Udall Heinrich and Senator Ben Ray Lujan, had made sure that you could actually purchase the cows themselves. The problem? The USDA never enacted regulations to allow for that. So we have been pushing the USDA to enact those regulations, on a fast track basis so that they can purchase the cows from Highland Dairy and help Highland Dairy kind of get back on their feet because they've been suffering through this. It's been an economic ruin for them and we need to fix it. So the DOD, the Department of Defense, kind of caused the problem. The EPA is going to be looking at the environmental aspects, but USDA itself is going to help with solving the immediate problem. I spoke about this directly with the USDA secretary because he spent 2 days with me here last month.
Okay. So if this bill that passed the House, if it passes the Senate, is signed into law, do we have a sense of how quickly the EPA will actually act on enacting a drinking water standard, classifying PFAS as a hazardous waste? How many years are we looking at, do you think?
We're hoping it won't be years and years because everybody recognizes that this is a serious issue that has been ignored. It was ignored by the past administration because they didn't want to deal with it. But now we know that it has these just drastic consequences for our health, for our drinking water, for our food supply. So we're hopeful that it will happen quickly. I will say the bill passed with bipartisan support on the floor of the House. So we are looking for bipartisan support in the Senate and hopefully we'll move quickly. Everybody recognizes the urgency of addressing this forever chemical so that we don't, you know, destroy our groundwater.
Mm-hmm. So we've been talking about the EPA specifically with this bill. Just to switch gears a little bit to the Defense Department, Congress has repeatedly put funding and mandates into the annual appropriations bill to set timelines for the military for cleanup, to set all sorts of ways for them to move forward. And frankly, they have not in many aspects. And I'm curious at this point, like, does Congress have control over the U.S. military in terms of getting them to clean up this forever problem?
So Congress can appropriate, but it's up to the administration to take the action that we appropriated the money for and that we said you must do this. So what we saw in the last administration, that there wasn't an urgency about addressing these environmental concerns. And we have now raised it. I raised it with Cannon Air Force Base directly the minute I got in as a congresswoman and met with them. It's one of the first things we talked about. They recognize that we are looking at them now, that we are going to be doing that kind of oversight to make sure they take action on what Congress has directed them to do. And we have, with this administration, the Biden administration recognizes the importance of addressing contamination, and especially in disadvantaged communities. And that's exactly what we are seeing in Clovis. So we have right now the means, the funding, but we also have the motivation in President Biden's administration to get this done. So we are very hopeful.
So we know how important the military is economically to New Mexico, but we also know we look across at military and DOD or DOE installations across the state, and they are big polluters in our state. And when we look at, even if we do get to the cleanup phase for some of these problems, it's millions, in some cases billions of dollars. With PFAS, we're not even sure what kind of a cleanup can occur. Looking out to the long term, how do we know that we're making the right choices for future generations and kind of continuing this relationship where we rely so heavily on the military, and yet it's causing such great long-term damage in our state?
What we need to do with the military, which we do rely on, is constantly look at what can we put in place to prevent any future environmental harms, and then fully fund the cleanup that's required. This was another issue. You know, LANL's in my district. We all know that. You referred to the DOE. We need to make sure that we fully fund the cleanup at LANL, because there's that legacy. And then when we talk about what else are we going to be doing on these bases or doing at LANL, that we do the full environmental review that NEPA calls for. Our National Environmental Policy Act calls for full environmental reviews of what we do when we take federal action. We have not always done that in the past, but we are going to start insisting on it now in moving forward in the future, because we cannot move forward in a way that sacrifices, you know, our grandchildren, our children for a few jobs. We need to recognize that we can do both. We can both have a thriving economy and have a focus and a priority on our environmental needs and our environmental cleanup, and making sure that we protect this beautiful place we call home. I always call it this beautiful place we call home, whether it's New Mexico or the planet, and that we must always take all our actions with that in mind, of how do we protect this beautiful, beautiful place that we get to call home.
All right. Congresswoman, thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it.
Well, I loved being here. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you.